worst fathers in paternity court.
I'm waiting for the evidence.
And Your Honor,
don't you say hickeys again.
Okay, Your Honor.
Because hickeys don't make babies.
Could you handle being in my shoes? Could you handle not having your mother not in your life and then your father leaving you? Could you imagine what your life could be like? Could you imagine how hard it is for you to avoid the streets?
Mr. Gower is in court today to finally confront his bad dad, the one refused his paternity for almost 24 years.
You are here to prove to Mr. Ducat that he is your biological father. It has been more than 16 years since you laid eyes on the man you believe is your father. Are you ready to see him?
Yes, Your Honor.
But the alleged father was still not ready to show the young man compassion.
When you just walked up, I looked at Mr. Gower. You couldn't really even look at him. You didn't look at him. You didn't look at one another.
No particular reason.
You're not the plaintiff's biological father, and you claim you had a one-night stand with Mr. Gower's mother, and she was in a long-term relationship at the time with another man, and that he is the biological father.
Yes, Your Honor.
However, what Mr. Gower told the court was a life lesson to all bad dads out there.
For 24 years of my life, not having no mother, losing her when I was 4 years old, my father just stranded me, knowing the pressure that I'm gonna have to deal with by myself. Even if I had a child of my own, I would never leave my child stranded. If that's my own blood, you're not considered no man to me. You're a coward.
Mr. Ducasse, on the other hand, was still unaffected by all of this.
What he's experienced, what he's felt, how do you stand by and be so emotionless? You truly don't believe you're his biological father?
No, Your Honor. At the time, she basically made it clear to me that she wasn't sure.
Why did you name him Sanchez after your best friend? You came to the hospital.
No,
said his head was shaped just like yours.
The unruffled father told his reason for not playing along.
She was in a two-year standing relationship and she made it real clear to me. We only had one encounter of which I used a withdrawal method. So actually, to speak honestly, I've never, you know, fully finished the act.
So you develop a friendship, but it is your testimony that you were only intimate with her one time.
Yes.
He next told Mr. Gower why he was so cold towards his family.
I was really upset with the fact that when your mom passed, I didn't even get informed by your family. I didn't get invited to the funeral.
You don't
guess
get
what
invited
happened?
To
Stop
a funeral.
It. Stop it.
I know
she died.
My only child.
Do you know how I know she died? A friend of mine called me and told me.
It made you feel even further away from the family.
I
like
ostracized.
Is that, however, a good reason to abandon your child? No, not at all.
My grandparents found you. They invited you over and they welcomed you. You told me, call me dad.
Now,
did you?
No.
Did
at
you not?
My apartment. No. Yes, you did,
Leroy. Did you not?
No, I don't remember that at all.
Oh, forgetting that? Real bad, man.
I try to stay strong, and sometimes it's real hard. That's why I want to major in child psychology, because I hate seeing young kids, especially, go through stuff like this. How can men, and that's what I just don't understand, how can men have sex with women, get them pregnant, and then just leave them and put a toll on that child when this child didn't ask to be here?
And what Mr. Gower said had us all in tears. But now, it was time for their pain to end.
Could you handle being in my shoes? Could you handle not having your mother not in your life and then your father leaving you? Could you imagine what your life could be like? Could you imagine how hard it is for you to avoid the streets?
It has been determined by this court. Mr. Ducasse, you are the father.
This next father on the list is overburdened with parental duties and wishes they would end.
Mr. Jackson, you say that 41 years ago, you were falsely accused of fathering a little girl, and that accusation has ruined your life, cost you tens of thousands of dollars, steady employment, and your health. Today, you are here to prove the defendant is not your daughter. Is that correct?
Yes, Your Honor.
So the judge started with an accusation part.
He has definitely ruined me financially wise, health wise, mental wise. It's at the point where I can't get driver's license, I can't get passport, I used to couldn't keep a job. It ruined my heart, Your Honor, to where I have a pacemaker in me now. The stress of it ruined my heart.
Doubts and debts were the reason for this trial. But the real victim was the girl at the podium.
18 years, Your Honor, I did not know that I owe child support. And I get a job with a paycheck. It's when I find out I owe child support. I could never catch up, Your Honor.
I was always told by him as a young girl that he had doubt. He would basically just try to mention he didn't think that he was the only man that my mom slept with. And
how old were you when he was saying this?
9 or 10 or 11 years old.
Wow. that is one hard pill to swallow.
You did have a relationship with Miss Jack.
It wasn't,
speaking of her mother?
It wasn't the kind of relationship that most daughters would have with their father.
What kind of relationship was
it? I considered him as a homie.
A homie?
Yeah, as a homeboy. And because of that, he never treated me as if I was really his daughter.
And the homie in the courtroom explained himself like this.
What was the nature of the relationship with Miss Jackson's mother?
At the time, I was married, and I knew it was wrong, but I did it.
So what happened when she told you she was pregnant?
I told her it was not my child, Your Honor.
Did you say that because you didn't believe that was your child? Or did you say that because you knew you were married and you knew you were wrong?
At that time, I believed a little both, Your Honor.
Then came some more excuses.
You have visitation. Did you see her regularly?
For years, I really didn't know where they were, Your Honor.
That's not true. He knew where we were. Mr. Jackson, he chose to live the life that he chose to live. He knew where we were. We wasn't very far. I stayed in contact with his mother. I stayed in contact with my siblings.
Next, young Jackson showed her birth certificate.
Juanisha Jackson. And listed under father is your name, Charles Jackson.
My name is actually Charlie Jackson Jr., Your Honor.
So
her mother called me Charles.
But your legal name is Charlie.
Charlie.
So you're saying the fact that Charles is written here is indicative of the fact mother gave the name and not you.
However, Daddy Jackson believed there was another man in the story.
There was another man at the time that I was seeing her mom. I'm going to say just her mom was fast. That's the way I'm going to put it.
So you're going to say respectfully that you felt like her mom was promiscuous?
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay, but that does not rule out the chance of paternity, does it?
Mother had came back together to live together. We had ice cream trucks in the neighborhood. One day, I asked my Mr. Jackson if I could have 25 cents so that I could buy ice cream. And he told me he didn't have it. And I said, well, do you have 10 cents? 15 cents?
Juanisha.
A nickel? And he said that he didn't have either or. But I would see him go to the liquor store and buy alcohol.
Wow, that's brutal. Now, let's end this woman's pain once and for all.
When it comes to 41-year-old Juanisha Jackson, it has been determined by this court, Mr. Jackson Jr., you are her father.
This young rapper got fooled by a married man who is now denying paternity.
You are summoning Mr. McKinley to court to prove to him and his wife that he fathered your 6-month-old son, Legend. Mr. McKinley, you admit that Ms. Thompson was an affair gone wrong, and you say Ms. Thompson needs to leave you and your wife of 17 years alone and find her baby's father. Is that correct?
Ms. Thompson was duped by the wrong bet. And she explained herself like this.
Consider it a relationship. I would consider it friends with benefits. I was on Facebook and he was always liking my pictures. He was commenting on my pictures. He was always trying to, I wouldn't be here today. Or we wouldn't even be asking if he was my baby. So yeah, he was attracted to me. I dated him. We had rap in common because I rap, you know, and I write music, I sing. I took him to the studio. We spit some bars.
But the thirsty baby daddy had his own version of the story lined up.
I post a picture of me leaving the studio. Ms. Thompson got in my DM. When you gonna bring me to the studio? I said, well, I don't know. Do you rap? She like, yeah,
she can't
rap.
Even rap.
I said, well, okay.
He can barely talk.
I live there and bring you today.
You know what?
So look, laying on
no,
that
I
day.
Don't.
However, the wife on the podium also had input to give.
The girls up there told me that my husband have a young girl in the room. In there, she laying under in the bed, under the cover.
Whose house was this?
I took the cover off her head. And I'm like, asking him, what's going on? Like, what we doing music? Sit down. I'm like, no, I won't sit down.
You doing music? In the bed under the
cover.
Miss Thompson told the court how she didn't want any of this.
I'm like, okay, this man too old for me.
Wait,
but at the time, it's fun right now because I'm young and I'm having fun and I'm enjoying his company. That's it. So I went to Tulane Hospital because I wasn't feeling good. He took me. I told him that I was expecting. I did not say it was his. I told him that I was expecting because I'm a woman. I'm a own up to my craft. So I said, okay, it's a chance that this might not be your child.
All right.
He was upset. He got in his feelings. This man is lying.
Next, a bunch of evidence was thrown around.
I asked Terrell about my son. I told him about it. Oh, yeah, that's me. So if that ain't your baby, take your shoe out. Let me see your
I'd like to see
we
your
got
evidence.
This about 3 months ago.
Yeah, come on.
Through a that's text that telling my husband.
And it was this picture, and the caption was
Legend's
real father.
Yes, good
yeah,
job.
I have nothing to hide. I did not say that.
You can go ahead and prove it.
So how do you think
they
got
this text if it didn't come from you?
And that pushed the overwhelmed baby mama to this.
So I can get the help that I need because I'm struggling with my child. If you want to meet her, that's fine. But she don't got to tag along your coattail just to go see your child.
This about her
yes, it
with
is.
My husband.
It's about
she
my child.
She calls me on my phone. She calls me and my husband. We let it go to voicemail. She called us. I got voicemails. I got text messages.
I think
she
should be more mature than that and take in consideration that stuff happens and she doesn't need to be a pain in my behind.
She even had a rap composed for all the situations.
Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Thompson has the courtroom.
Let me tell you a little something about me. Pretty Mac Kool-Aid solo grinding one deep. I met him on Facebook. He inboxed me. Trying to see if he could take me out to eat. I'm knowing this dude want to get in them sheets. I'm from Triple D, so I'm so discreet. Make the dude say he want to marry me. I don't got time. I'm on my grind. Money, 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 that's on my mind. He got me pregnant. Stuff got hectic. I got on that phone and start talking reckless. I can't help it. I be stressing. But my kids, yeah, they a blessing.
So, now that note, let's move to the results.
Mr. McKinley, you are the father.
What is a good way to get out of paternity? Well, blame the mother for infidelity and being a gold digger. And Mr. Campbell is playing that trumpet.
Mr. Campbell, you are here today because you say your ex-girlfriend is nothing but a conniving, gold-digging cheater whose goal is to pin her 9-month-old son legacy on you. McSear, you say Mr. Campbell is a compulsive liar who's denying your son out of spite because you no longer want to be with him.
Yes, Your Honor.
Mr. Campbell testified himself like this.
Once I ran out of money, she left me high and dry. I'm just here today to prove that this is not my son so she can get out of my life.
And so you don't believe you're the father, not one bit.
Your Honor.
And you believe this Miss McSear just feel like she got her one.
Your Honor, I think, a fish on the hook, Your
She's
Honor.
She's trying. That's what you think you are.
That's another lie.
But Mrs. McSear, on the other hand, found her baby daddy's claims funny.
We were in a relationship and we stayed together and we was together every day.
Your Honor, I went through her phone on numerous occasions and I seen her talking to different men inappropriately, outrageous. How can I trust somebody who talks to different men, who sends their pictures to different men, explicit pictures to different men, and you expect me to think we're in an exclusive relationship?
And even the next accusation did not make her flinch.
Sleeping with married men. She is known for that. She is known for being a homewrecker. She is known for breaking up happy homes. That's the type of person that she is, Your Honor.
Really?
She says I'm the compulsive liar, but no, she's the compulsive liar.
You're definitely the compulsive liar.
She's the compulsive liar.
Next, the judge counted back the conception date.
So give me Legacy's birth date.
June 15th, 2018.
Of 2018, all right? And if you'll hit calculate, we see that the window of conception would be approximately September 20th to September 24th, and the date of intercourse would have been somewhere between September 17th to September 24th.
Yeah, we also got tired of that charade. But it went on.
And you done bought 2 packs of diapers. He's 9 months.
You taking it till this day.
That's $40.
She's a gold digger. Your Honor, she don't care about me having a relationship with him. She cares about me giving her money. Now she's trying to
I
get
really
my parents.
I really think I'm the lick.
Now she's trying to get money from her parents now.
Oh.
That's exactly what it is. She's trying
Your
to get stuff from my
like
parents.
You.
But wait. Mr. Campbell had his very unconvincing evidence brought up too.
Four really? Different men and she cannot deny that. Yes, can you? Can. Your Honor.
4 different men holding the baby?
Yes, Your Honor, sending the pictures to me, and in those pictures, none of them was me. So are you 100% sure that I am the father of this child? But you're sending me pictures of somebody else holding this child? Just random men that she have sexual relationships with.
How do you know I had sexual relations? That's
because they're laying in your bed. They're holding your son.
And baby mama totally denied the validity of the evidence.
Any of these pieces of evidence true?
One man and a baby, maybe. But the unknown man and the paternity test, definitely a lie.
So you've never had a DNA test with
another
man pertaining to legacy.
Because there's no other man. There's no problem.
So what got revealed next made us go, oh, across the screen.
When I bring him around, what happens? When
I
bring him around, what happens?
Your Honor,
when I bring him around, what happens? 2 seconds into the visit, you're in my face trying to figure out who I'm with and what I'm doing. You don't worry about your son. That is not your concern.
That is a lie. That's
no,
a lie.
No, you're a lie. And you plead the fifth.
I did. I might have said a few things to her, but me crying at the door, now that's going overboard. And
so you haven't cried before?
I have cried before.
Okay, so we know this happened.
All right.
Okay, now, let's just slap some DNA results into this liar's face.
Mr. Campbell, you are the father.
When it comes to fooling around with women, you should step up and accept the situation. But Mr. Miles isn't much of a man.
Murphy, you claim you had a short, passionate relationship with the defendant, Mr. Miles, and then you became pregnant. Now you say he's married and wants to forget he has a 3-year-old son. Mr. Miles, you argue that the only person you're trying to forget is Ms. Murphy. You deny paternity of her son and say another man is his biological father.
The trial began with Ms. Murphy explaining what kind of father the defendant was.
Man has not done anything for my son. I can count on one hand how many times he's ever even came to visit his son. On top of that, he refers to my son as the boy. The boy, how's the boy doing? How's your son doing? What's his name again? Him and his daughter, they all look alike. They all have the same face, but he won't acknowledge that at all.
She even told the court how he reacted to the pregnancy.
I don't want you to have this baby. This is not okay. I don't need this type of attention. He didn't need it. You know, he was man enough to make that baby, but he can't be man enough to take care of it.
This is exactly what I told her.
He wasn't willing to pay for the paternity test other way. Said he didn't have the money for it. If that's the case, Your Honor, we would not be here.
And Mr. Miles defended himself like this.
Well, Your Honor, first and foremost, I never said that I didn't want to do things for him. I just was under the impression that it was not my son due to the fact of stuff that was told to me. Your Honor, to say it was a relationship, I couldn't say that. I could say it was more of we were cool, we were friends, you know. I wouldn't say it was a relationship.
He even explained to the judge why he was skeptical in the first place.
Family members told me that she was getting around.
The family members that he was sleeping with told
Ms.
him
Murphy,
that.
Ms. Murphy knew that I was already dealing with one of her family members. She knew that.
Never did
she
I.
She knew that.
So you were
never
in a sexual relationship with a family member.
Correct, and she knew that.
Before never
Your
you
Honor.
Two had a sexual relationship.
Your Honor.
Yes, and she was fully aware of the doubt to not listen to what everybody else was telling me, but she pretty much painted the picture for herself on what she was about.
Ms. Murphy, on the other hand, had no idea where all the accusations were coming from.
He was dealing with any of my family. That's ridiculous. About it being an open relationship, he told me plenty of times that he loved me, you know, all this type of stuff.
It's possibilities of not because the type of lifestyle that she carried around. Now, one thing about me,
but
one
you,
thing
you
about
got
me,
around too, though.
One thing about
every
me,
girl in Fresno knows Kiba, though.
Okay. One thing about me, and a lot of the men know you.
And this throwing blame on the mama annoyed the judge, too.
Sufficient evidence to believe why you wouldn't think you potentially could be this beautiful young man? I'm waiting for the evidence.
And Your Honor,
don't you say hickeys again.
Okay, Your Honor.
Because hickeys don't make babies. I want to know what evidence you have. Fuels your doubt.
I never said that it wasn't a possibility he couldn't be my child.
Next, Mr. Miles' wife was brought up, and she did no good to trial either.
And you are Mr. Miles's
wife.
Do you take issue with Ms. Murphy because of this or with your husband?
Kind of both.
We have a statement in this courtroom. Order in the court. I'm trying to tell you all are way off the path to something constructive. Everything is leading us in the wrong direction.
But wait. Ms. Murphy also had her witness in the courtroom.
Everything he know, I teach him. He got favorite colors. His favorite color is my favorite color. We play games. I taught him his colors. I taught him his numbers, his ABCs. Taught him everything that he knows. When he wake up in the morning, the first thing he do, he wake me up. Daddy, I'm hungry. Daddy, I love you. Good morning, Daddy. When he's hurt, he don't go to mommy. He goes to daddy. When I go to work, he cries even though his mom is there.
Wow. Preach, man.
If Kiba was the father, I gave Kiba chances to be there for Sakori, and he didn't take them.
When you say you gave him chances, what did you do to reach out to him?
I told him he can come and see Sakori. I didn't care. You know, I let them go outside, have fun time, have father-son time, let them do, you know what I mean? Like, be a part of your son's life. You know what I mean? That's what I let him do.
But he keeps coming in and out.
So now it was time to end this confusion back and forth.
It's becoming heads yapping, and the DNA results are in. You two are parents, but he also has step parents. You all are his village, but you're burning it down.
You can begin again today for this beautiful child's sake. The court has resources for you.